For many of you in Europe, you already know what this is. But for us Americans, this is fall running apparel from a company called Decathlon. You won't recognize any of the brand names because they make all their own stuff. It's like a Trader Joe's, but for outdoor gear. And the prices are unbelievably affordable. But at those low prices, can these products still perform? It's time to try on this gear and put Decathlon to the test. Minutes total on the bike for today, 14.5 miles per hour and 129 beats per minute on what is my cross training day. Not exactly a rest day, but a cross training day as I get ready for CIM. And today I wore a long sleeve quarter zip and some running gloves from Kalenji, a brand that's part of Decathlon. Now, before I give you my thoughts on this gear and some of the trail running gear that I've also been reviewing from Decathlon, I do want to go over some disclosures. All these pieces are items that were sent to me by Decathlon for the purpose of review. However, they're not paying me to make this video or to use these items, and they're not going to get a chance to preview any of my footage or my thoughts before this video goes up on YouTube. So with those disclosures out of the way, let's talk about this gear from Decathlon. So Decathlon is something that I've been aware of for a while now. A lot of you guys have been kind of asking me about stuff, but usually those of you who are asking me about stuff are usually people from Europe. They're a company that I believe originated in France, and they've kind of taken like an Aldi's or a Trader Joe's type of model and applied it to outdoor goods. They do have actual physical stores in the US, which is kind of amazing in a time where like physical stores are disappearing, but I guess in retail, everything that's old is new again. And in these stores, they kind of have like everything. So it's like those sporting mega good stores, and there's like a house brand by Decathlon for everything. I'm going to talk about two of those house brands today, Evadict and Kalenji. First, let's talk about the Evadict stuff. And the first thing I want to talk about is this like half zip short sleeve trail running shirt. It has grippy parts at the top on the shoulders, and that's so that way when you do have a running pack on, that running pack won't slip around, so it's a little bit of extra grip. But the material itself is very much like a cycling jersey. It is very, very thin, and it even has some pockets in the back. There are pockets in kind of like the lower left and then the lower right that are big enough where you can definitely drop in something like a gel. And it's even got like a little bit of like kind of a lip on top of that pocket, so nothing's gonna really bounce out of those two back pockets. The material itself is very stretchy but also very breathable, so even though it seems like kind of like weird to me to have a zipper on my running shirt, this actually worked out really well, and I've worn it both with the pack and without a pack, and I've enjoyed it both of those times. This is a shirt that I'm probably going to take for my next trail race. I've got one coming up this weekend. Every time I put this shirt on, I do feel like it's kind of like a little bit more of a special shirt, more like kind of like a race singlet, but with sleeves. And so it feels a little bit more special to me, and it's definitely something that I like. And the amazing thing about it is this shirt is just $35. So an amazing price for what I would consider like, you know, race caliber type of apparel. And it's been through several washes already, and it still looks like it's brand new. It's holding up really well so far. So I mean, I'm really impressed with this first item that they sent me, the Evadict Zip Trail Running Tee. Now to go with that, they also sent me a pair of Evadict running shorts. Now there's a couple of different shorts that have kind of like the same like pocket system, and then there's like different like bottoms to it in terms of like how the different Evadict trail running shorts are kind of configured. And the one that I have is the Trail Running Comfort Tight. And what sets this one apart is that there is kind of, it's like a two-in-one short. So underneath here, there is a kind of like a compression short that's part of the short. So there's like the outer shell, then there's a longer compression short, so it kind of like pokes out of the bottom. And then there's also a liner that's more of like a brief. So there's kind of like three layers that are in here. Now in terms of pockets, this thing is amazing in terms of how many pockets it has. You guys know I love pockets, especially on trail shorts. So there's a kind of like a kangaroo pouch in the front, and in some of the pictures that they show, there is like a little water bottle, I think, that Decathlon sells. I don't know how many ounces. It didn't look terribly big, but you could fit a little bit, like a mini speed flask type of thing in the front kangaroo pouch. And behind it, there's a zipper area. So if you have something like car keys, this is a really small area down here. So there's something like car keys or a house key that you wanted to make sure that you didn't lose and you wanted to make sure that it was secure, there's a zippered pocket in the front. Along each side, there are not one, but two pockets. So you've got kind of like a front side and a back side pocket. So there's one kangaroo pocket, side pockets, backside pockets, and then on the back there is another zippered pocket, and this was big enough to fit my iPhone 11 in there with a case on. And so that is something that you put in there, or if it's a day where you don't have the phone, it's a place where you could stash a bunch of gels. And the pockets worked out really well for me. I took both this and the shirt out. The main testing day for me was that day I went and ran Star of Rock State Park, a couple hours, like an hour and a half southwest of here in Chicago. And these were great for that day. I absolutely loved having these on. The shorts aren't perfect though. There's a couple of drawbacks to them. And one is that these pockets that are on the side, I kind of wish that there's a little divider in here that's sewn in here. And I don't know if I can kind of maybe break this seam. I probably can't without destroying the pant, but I wish that this was one bigger pocket instead of two smaller pockets. Cause a lot of the gels that I like the Science and Sport, or the Martin gels, are a little bit bigger than say like Goose. And so the Science and Sport gel, I had a real hard time fitting it in here. And then when it did fit in there, it actually kind of poked through a little bit of the mesh. So it's like, you can jam a lot of stuff in here, but you gotta be a little bit careful because this mesh is very flexible, but it's not like the most like rip proof or tear proof type of material. So I was able to already poke a little bit of a hole in it, but it otherwise has been able to hold all my gels fine. I do like the pocket in the front, but like it seems like they're with the double pocket in here, like this little zipper pocket and then the kangaroo pouch up front, it feels like maybe a little bit too much like on the belly, and it just makes the pants look a little bit weird if you're gonna put a lot in there. And because these side pockets aren't quite big enough for me, I found myself like wanting to put like kind of more in the front pocket, which then kind of just makes it look like you've got a little bit of a paunch, which I don't know, maybe it's I'm being too vain, but I just didn't love that. The rear pocket I thought worked out great. I love rear pockets because like you could put a lot of stuff there and it's not going to bounce a lot because it's in the small of the back. The other thing that I didn't love about these shorts, and I think it's because it's the two-in-one version that I have here that have this little peek through area, they make one that doesn't have like the two-in-one part, and I think that's probably would be better for me because I felt like there's the outer shell, there's the two-in-one, like this compression layer part that is not super compressive but very comfortable against the skin, so I did like it. But then there's still like an inner liner that's a brief, so there's really three layers of clothing that are in these shorts. And on a hot summer day, that ended up just kind of being a lot. And it also exacerbated the other thing that I think is going on with these, is that they do run like a little bit small. I felt like mediums were like a little bit on the snug side for me. So I would probably recommend for most people in the US to maybe size up a little bit because this felt really like tight by the end of the day. And I don't know if it's just because there's three layers of pant in here or if that's just the way the waistband is sized, but I think part of the reason why they want to make it so tight is because you got so many pockets in here, you don't want all the weight to kind of like drag down the pant. But it did feel just a touch too snug. But overall, at a price of $40, you get a pair of pants that functions exceedingly well. And it, again, it's a pair of pants that I will happily take out for a race. And again, it's probably going to be a pair of pants that I wear this weekend for my next trail race, which is going to be a half marathon. I'm probably not going to, you know, race it all out. It's going to be a long run workout for me. But I am planning on having some fun and letting it rip like a little bit. not too much, just a little bit out on the trails. And these will be some pants that I take with me because they are really, really functional. So now let's flip over from Evadict to another brand within Decathlon, which is Kalenji. Decathlon sent me two things. First, they sent me a pair of running gloves. And these are running gloves that have like the touch sensitive parts, like on the thumb and like on the forefinger. So you could still use like your Apple Watch if you're touching your screens. I use these both on the bike today because it was about like 50 something degrees on the bike. So it was a little bit chilly and I was worried, like, you know, with the speed on the bike, the wind, you know, that my hands would get a little bit cold. So I was happy to have the gloves on for today. I also used them a couple of days ago when I was up in the suburbs running the Lublin Memorial 5K. It was in like the low 50s, almost in the high 40s for the start of the race. And so I wore these gloves not only for my warm up, but also during the entire race. And they were perfect for that kind of weather. I'm usually like the first person to start wearing gloves during like the transition from like summer to fall or from fall to winter. So for most people, that weather probably isn't glove weather. For me, it's kind of like maybe it is, maybe it isn't, but these are pretty thin. And I thought that for that kind of like transitional, maybe I need gloves, maybe I don't, I thought these gloves were great. And I felt like they gave me just the right amount of kind of like warmth for like this kind of like, we're starting to get into some chillier temps in the fall. So I thought these were perfect. And at a price of $9, it's kind of at that price where like I could get one if I lose one during a race, or if like during a race, like they're bothering me and I wanna toss them at like an aid station. That's definitely something I could do and not worry too much about being so wasteful. And so I feel like this is like a glove that's not going to take me deep into the winter, but for right around now, once we're starting to get into those fall temps, this is like the perfect pair of gloves that I would want to have, and also a pair of gloves that I would probably bring with me for any of like my fall marathons, where it's kind of like you might need a throwaway layer, like a long sleeve, maybe some joggers, maybe a hat and some gloves that you want to have on in the corrals, but you'll take off either during the race or right before the race starts. I feel like these $9 gloves are going to be perfect for that. Now, the last thing that they sent was this quarter zip, and they're calling this the warm long sleeve running tee. But for me, it's definitely like a pullover. It's a quarter zip. It's got like almost like a micro fleece on the inside. It's very soft and feels to me like it's a little bit warmer than just like a long sleeve tee or like a long sleeve quarter zip. So this is definitely something that I think can take me a little bit deeper into the fall than maybe the running gloves could. It's got really nice thumb holes. It's got a reflective Kalenji logo on the back with a little bit of a reflective stripe. And the amazing thing about this is that it's just $15. I don't know how they're bringing it in at that price, but that's an amazing price. And so something that's very easy for me to recommend, something that you could pick up. The fit is great. I went with the medium on this one too, and this fits me just fine. So no issues with sizing on this one. And it's something that I've been wearing around casually as well as on the bike and as on the run. So it's a pretty versatile piece that I feel like just kind of works. So far I've had this stuff for a little while. I haven't put like super thorough testing in it. Each of these items only has like a couple of washes on them each. So I'll be wearing them a lot more and you guys will get a chance to see kind of like how these pieces are holding up over time, especially given the price. It might be something that you guys are interested in. So hit that subscribe button so you could see any follow-up videos that I make on any of these pieces, or so you could see any of the races or any of the other runs that I'll be taking this gear on. If you have any questions about these particular pieces, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. I wouldn't say like I'm an expert on all Decathlon things because they just make so many different things. They cover pretty much like every sport imaginable. But of these things, I'll be happy to answer any questions you have, or better yet, feel free to stop by the live stream that I do Monday through Friday right here on YouTube. I'd love to talk to you guys in the chat. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. Hopefully you guys are staying safe out there on your runs, and I'll see you in the next one. Yo, what's going on?